Hi, I'm Doug McMillan from Hondata and I'm here today at D-Sport for a test and tune on the new manual transmission 2017 Civic. I'm really excited. This is the first time that we've had the ability to do a test and tune and test a variety of things, and it's going to be a control situation. We're going to be testing a number of variables all on the same dyno. The engine that's found in the Civic is going to be found in a lot of other Civics. It's going to be in the next CR-V, and I have a suspicion it's going to be seen in a lot of other Honda models as well. Honda's going turbo, and Honda's going turbo big time. We're going to learn a lot from our test and tune today. What we've just finished with the baseline Hondata reflash that we've got for these vehicles, and the results are great. We've picked up pretty much 20 horsepower everywhere, from the turbo spool, which is just around 3000 RPM, up to just under 5500, 6000 RPM. So the area under the curve in terms of power that we've gained is absolutely fantastic. We've picked up everywhere. And you know the nice thing about this engine? It's not just about power, it's about fuel economy too. It's a well-designed engine. Even at these power levels, if you drive it gently, you should be able to get 40 to 50 mile per gallon. Well, we just finished the testing with the Mishimoto intake and the results are good. They're pretty much what we expected. The Mishimoto intake has actually added 10 horsepower at around 6,000 RPM, which with the stock air filter is struggling to pass the required air that we need for the increased amount of boost that we've got. The Mishimoto intake on top of the Hondata reflash has given us 10 peak horsepower, and that's great. With this run, with the engine intercooler, we've added torque and power to the mid-range to the top end. This is great. They're sort of like one is added to the bottom, one is added to the top, and the torque curve is now looking very flat. This is a very, very drivable torque curve. For the next session, I'm going to do a custom tune to add a little bit more torque and power. Now, I'm not too sure how much the clutch and this gearbox will take, so I'm not going to add much peak torque around 3000 RPM, but I'm going to add torque from 3.5 to 4,000 RPM up, and let's just see what we can do with the 91 octane. Well, we've just completed a custom tune with the Flashbow to see how much more boost and power we can get out of this, and the results have been pretty good. We've picked up about 15 pound-feet of torque in the mid-range and about 5 horsepower at the top end. I think maybe the turbocharger is running out of capacity at the top end, but what is relevant is that the knock control is showing an increase in knock at these high boost levels. So I think we're at the limit of what we can do with 91 octane. Let's put some high octane fuel in and see what it does. We've just completed our runs with the high octane fuel and the result's great. We've now hit 237 pound-feet of torque in the mid-range, which is pretty phenomenal for a 1.5 engine like this. This is V6 torque out of a 1.5 engine, but we're not really making much, if anything, at the top end. I have a feeling that we're past the efficiency range of what the turbocharger has been designed to operate in. So we've gone through a whole range of different things on the Civic. We started off with the Hondata Flash Pro, and then followed it up with the Mishimoto intake, the engine intercooler, and then the high octane fuel. And the results have been great. We've gained around 30 horsepower, which doesn't seem like that much, but we've picked up around 54 pound-feet of torque. So the area under the curve is absolutely tremendous. the drivability of this car is going to be transformed. It's going to be so much fun for people to drive these cars and to modify them with everything that you can do with this 1.5 Civic Turbo right now.